Hello, good morning students. See, this is your fourth lecture of chapter 2, dual effects of accounts and types of accounts. Dual effect of transactions and types of accounts. And see here, we complete up to illustration number 4 in our last lecture. But here I am giving a small brief of chapter up to this. We will complete that. See here, first of all, we show that business transactions. What is that? See, business transactions, that means the transactions in which the person, two persons, minimum two persons, exchange goods and goods, services and cash, and this is called a transactions. And if it is measured in money, then it is a business transaction. Okay, now see, we classify them into economic and non-economic transactions, and under that we classified, subclassified that if it is economic transactions, then cash and credit transactions. We have to find out it is cash transactions or it is a credit transaction. So after business transactions, we classified these transactions into economic and non-economic, and if economic, then it is into cash and credit. After that, see, we show that into the business transactions, which two accounts are affected, that means dual effect of each and every transactions. Right, we show which two accounts are affected into each and every transactions, and we can say that it's a types of it's a dual effect of our transactions. And now see, after that we show that types of accounts, we classify again that particular two account, affected two accounts, which we have to classify that into three, that is personal account, real account and nominal account. So see, this is the process. See here, we are not complete our accounting process. Here we are in the stage of this. We classify all the affected accounts into the transactions in three types, that is first is personal, second is real, and third one is nominal. And in our last lecture, we show that illustration number 4, that is number 50, sorry, 40 accounts are given, and we have to classify them into three types of accounts. Okay, now, and I told you that you have a homework of illustration number 5, in that 50 accounts are given, and again you have to classify that 50 accounts into three different types of accounts, that is personal, real and nominal. I hope you all complete that. But here I am giving a speedy brief of 50 accounts, that if you don't understand any of the accounts, which type of account is there, then you can understand that. That's why I am giving you a speedy brief of this illustration number 5. So that first, classify the following accounts and give one brief explanation. I am not here giving you any explanation, I am just give you which type of account is that, right? Bills receivable account. See, bills receivable is our assets, but bills receivable is depends on the debtors. See, the process is, I told you that first of all, I am selling the goods. So the first transaction is sales. Then I am selling the goods on credit basis. See, the debtors is not give me any amount right now. Okay, and see here, if the sales is on the credit basis, then see that sales, on the basis of sales, debtors creditors relations is emerge, right? I am doing a sales on credit basis, then debtors is emerged from that particular sales. Now, after 15 days, after the term of the 15 days, he told me that I have no money right now. Give me a 2 or 3 months extra time to give your money, pay your money, right? So at that time, I am writing a bill that is called a bills receivable. So here, first transaction is sales. At that time, I am doing a sales on the credit basis. Then that's why debtors creditors relations is emerged. At the time of due date, that means after 10 or 15 days, the term is complete. He told me that I have no money right now. I want 2 or 3 months extra to pay your money. Debtors told me, right? That's why I am writing a bill on the debtor, and here debtor is cancelled, bills receivable is emerged. That means bills receivable means what? Here I am writing a bill on that particular person, that is on the debtors, and here I am giving a 2 to 3 months extra time to pay my money, to pay sales money, right? That is bills receivable. So here it is two. Here bills receivable, you can say it's a personal account because it is a representative personal account. Bills receivable represent debtors. That's why it is a personal account, as well as bills receivable is our assets. We have to receive some money from the debtors. That's why it is also our current assets. It is our current assets, right? So here you can write bills receivable account is a personal account, as well as it is a assets account, and you can say it's a current assets account. Next point, see, value added tax account. See, value added tax. See, any tax is our expense of the business. Tax we have to pay to government. That's why tax is our expense. And that's why it is a nominal account. It is an expense account. Okay. So value added tax, GST, that is goods and service tax. Okay. Any tax is your expense of the business. Okay. Next point, bills payable. Again, same procedure. See here, purchase. First of all, purchase is made on credit basis. I am not giving any amount right now. I am just purchasing the goods. That's why it is a credit purchase, and that's why creditors debtors relationship is emerged. So from purchase, creditors is there, okay? And if I am at the time of due date, after 10 or 15 days, if I am not able to pay the money to creditors, then creditor will give me a bills payable and I am accept it. That means he give me a 2 or 3 month extra time to pay the money. That is called bills payable. Again, it is representation of creditors. That's why it is a personal account. Here, it is not our assets. We have to pay this our liability. That's why it is only a personal account. See, bills receivable and bills payable, both debtors and creditors, both are personal accounts. But here, debtors and bills receivable, both are also your assets. Okay, so that's why you can say it's our real account also. Bills payable and debtors is also your real account, as well as here bills payable, debtors, creditors and bills receivable all are your personal account. Okay, it is a representative personal account. Fourth, Bijal's account. Obviously it's a natural personal account. The name of the person is given. That's why it's a natural personal account. Then closing stock account. Closing stock, that is our assets. That's why it is a current asset. That's why it's a real account. Okay. Next point, Himani, again the person, natural person, that's why natural personal account. Patent account, see, patent is your assets. See, what is that? I was explaining you in our regular lecture because it's a big story of about patent. So, patent, copyright, trademark and goodwill. Four, you can write here, you can write in your fair book, goodwill, patent, trademark and copyright. We will understood these four points, these four intangible assets in our regular lecture, but you here you can just understand that these four are your fixed assets, or you can say intangible assets. That's why these four are your real accounts. Okay, complete. Now next point is Bank of Baroda account. See, again it's a artificial person, that's why it's a personal account. 9, bank overdraft account. Bank overdraft, see, it is our loan, that's why again it's a representing a bank. Bank overdraft means what? First of all, what is bank overdraft? See, in my accounts of bank, I have 50,000 rupees as a balance. Okay, I have a 50,000 rupees as a balance, and I am requesting to the bank, that is, I am writing an application to the bank that if they allowed me, bank allow me to pay more than amount into my account, then it is called a bank overdraft. First of all, for that I have to write an application for the bank and take a permission to pay more than amount that is not in my account. That means what? If I want to pay 1 lakh rupees to a party, 1 lakh rupees to one person, right? And I have only 50,500 or 55,000 in my accounts, bank account, then I can write 1 lakh rupees check? No, because if I am writing 1 lakh rupees check and the person goes to the bank and deposit the check into their account, here their check is bounced. What means of that? Here I have no sufficient balance to pay that particular money. I have a 55,000 only and I am writing a check of rupees 1 lakh to the party. At that time, first of all, I have to request to the bank, and that means I have to write an application to the bank that give me a 50,000, or you can say give me a 1 lakh rupees overdraft. That is a short term loan. You can say it's a short term loan. I have money only 55,000 into my bank balance and I want to pay 1 lakh rupees. So remaining amount is given by the bank as a short term loan to me. And whenever I have a money, I have to deposit that money into my account, and that time my balance, negative balance, will be positive or zero, right? So here, whenever I have not sufficient money to pay, first of all I have to request to the bank. See, request is only once. Whenever you are requesting for rupees 1 lakh, the 1 lakh is for all the period, right? You don't have to request at every time. Here you just have to request once that I want to take a bank overdraft of rupees 1 lakh, and that application I am submitted to bank and bank allow me, then I can write a check, I can issue a check to a party of 1 lakh rupees. And other than my, I have no sufficient balance, that check is not bounced and payment will be made from my bank account. And whenever I have a money, I have to deposit that money into my account, and that at that time bank overdraft is over. So here, in short, it is, you can say, bank overdraft means what? It's a short term loan. Here it is loan, that's why it is a personal account. It is represent bank, that's why it is a personal account. Okay, so here bank overdraft is your personal account. Next point, R&L, Pandya High School account, again it's a firm or institute, that's why you can say it's a personal account. Petty cash account, see, cash account and petty cash account, what means of that? See, there are a chapter, 6th or 7th chapter, that is cash account. In that case, we are understanding what is cash and what is petty cash. I am explaining you at that time. So here, petty cash is just your cash account, and here you can say cash account is your real account. Okay, so here petty cash, again it's your assets, that's why it's a real account. 12, Gujarat University, again institute, then it is a personal account. Next, interest on drawings account. Interest, see, drawing account is a personal account, but interest is your expense, right? Interest is your income. Here interest on drawings is your expense, that's why it is your nominal account. It is income or it is expense. Interest on drawings is income for the firm, and interest on drawings is a expense for the owner. That's why here on the, we are concentrate only on the centralized, we are the on the business. That's why, see here, for business, interest on drawings is a income, that's why it is a nominal account. Okay, interest on drawings is a nominal account, it's in our income, business income. Tata company account, again firm or company name, it's a personal account. Then interest on capital, see, interest on capital is an expense for the business and income for the owner. That's why we just have to concentrate business. That's why interest on capital is the expense, interest on drawings it's an income, and both are nominal account here. Next, share of Tata company account. See, if Tata company here, it's personal account, but share of Tata company, I told you at that time, if share word is given, then it is called an investment. An investment is your assets, that's why it is a real account. If only Tata company account is given, then it is what? It is a personal account, but share of Tata company, that is real account. Okay, then loan borrowed account. See, we are taking a loan from bank, from person, from anywhere, right? And from any financial institute. So it's loan borrowed account is again a representative personal account. That's why loan borrowed is your personal account. Now, next, debenture of Tata company account. Again, share as well as debenture, both are investment. Share of Tata company, debenture of Tata company, all you can say it's your investment, and investment is your real account. That's why here debenture of Tata company is a real account. Okay, interest paid, again it's your expense, paid word is there, that's why your expense, that's why it's a nominal account. Next, interest received on debenture account, again received word is there, that's why it's our income. Interest is nominal account, income account. Okay, next, insurance premium account. Insurance premium is your expense of the business, that's why again it's a nominal account. Next, bad debts return account. First of all, what is bad debts? Whenever I am doing a sales on credit basis, right, then I gave you that 5 or 10 days time to debtors, and then after 5 or 10 days, if debtors pay not pay me some amount, or you can say not pay me any amount, that is called bad debts for me. It is not my expense, it is a loss. See here, the terminology, all the terminology of part chapter 1 is used each and every time here. In again, I told you that if you don't understand all the terminology, please see again and again. See, I already know you, this language is also not familiar with you, and this subject is also new for you, but you have to do by this way, because we have no any way to do this. We cannot meet in our school, that's why we have to do this this type of educations. Okay, so if you have any problem, then anytime call me or WhatsApp me. about the accounts, but please do once that account is very difficult subject for all of you. Please do that, and if you have any doubts, then anytime ask me. Okay, so here, if you don't understand all the terminology, you don't understand all these things, so please again I request you that please show all the videos, all the past videos, or if you don't have that particular videos, then ask to the ma'am to give you that particular videos, and then you can understand all these things, because it is account is a link, right? I told you in my first lecture, introduction lecture, that accounts, all the chapters or accounts are linked with each other. So please do that. Okay, now see the what is bad debts. See, bad debts is our loss of the business. If the bad debts is returned, see, after sometimes debtors have money and he give me the money, the remaining money, that means what? It is a bad debt return. So whenever bad debts is there, it is your loss, but whenever bad debts return, what is there? That is your income, and that's why it is a nominal account. Bad debts return is your nominal account. Okay, office expense, again office expense, what is there? That's why it's a nominal account. Salary outstanding account, see, if salary account is there, then it is an expense account, but the word is salary outstanding. See, salary outstanding represent a person to whom I have to pay the salary. Salary outstanding account is represent a person, that is a worker, my staff, to whom I have to pay the salary. That's why salary outstanding account is a personal account. If salary account only is there, it is the expenses, it is nominal account, but salary outstanding word is there, receivable or outstanding, any of the word is represent a person. That's why it is a representative personal, or you can say it's a personal account. Okay, salary outstanding is a personal account. Sales expense, again expense, that's why it's a nominal account. Rent payable, see, again payable word is there, receivable, payable, outstanding, accrued, all word you have to write, or you have to remember all these words. See here, any expenses, any expenses is there, salary or rent, interest, but all are expenses as well as income, you can say, but the word outstanding receivable payable accrued, all word are, if attached with these accounts, see, if it is a simply salary, rent or interest account, then it's a nominal account, it is our expense, or you can say it is our income, so it's a nominal account, but the word is included with these, that means salary outstanding, rent receivable, rent payable, see, at that time here it becomes a personal account, because this word is represent a person. That's why it's a personal account. Salary outstanding is a personal account. Here again, rent payable is your personal account. Okay. Next, wages payable or outstanding. Again, it's a personal account. United Insurance Company Limited. Again, it's a firm or company name. So you can say it's a personal account, artificial personal account. Right? Railway freight account. See, what is railway freight? Freight means what? Freight means if I am sending a goods or I am receiving a goods by train. See, the transportation is your train. So you have to pay the freight for that. If you are transporting the goods through train, or you can say, then it is, you have to pay the charges, that is called a freight, to the railway, that is your, you charges is the your expense of the business. That's why transportation expenses, that's why you can say railway freight is your expense account, and you can say it's a nominal account. Okay, next, octroi, again one type of expense, that is transportation expense, that's why it's octroi is a nominal account. Machine repairing account, again repairing is your expense, that's why if machine account is there, it's your asset, and machine repairing account, repairing is your expense, that's why it's a nominal account. Vehicle account, again it's your real account, it's your assets, right? Next, dividend received, the word received, that is income. Dividend is your nominal account, dividend received account is your nominal, or you can say income account. Income tax, I told you, any type of tax, GST, value added tax, that is VAT, income tax, all or any type of tax is your expense of the business, that's why it's a nominal account. Ramaben account, again person, that's why personal account. Sarmistraben account, that is again a personal account. Vasani brothers account, it's an artificial person, that's why personal account. Jassani and Son, again it's a firm name, that's why it's a personal account. Vasani account, again it's a surname or person name, that's why you can say it's a personal account. Jassani account, again Jassani, Vasani, all are the surname, and you can say it's represent a person, that's why it's a personal account. Then commission received account, what is commission received? Again received, what is that? That's why it's a nominal account. Next, commission allowed, it's allowed means expense, expense, again it's a nominal account. Discount received, discount allowed, both are income and expenses, that's why nominal account. Next, stationery stock, see, if stationery account, then it is our expense. Stationery stock, word stock is means that it is your assets, it's your current assets, that's why it's a real account. If stationery account only is given, then it is a nominal, your business expenses, that's why nominal account. But the word stationery stock is there, then it is a real account. Now sales account, sales account, again it's, you can say real account as well as nominal account. I told you in illustration number 4, sales, if we are considered as an income, then it's a nominal account. And sales, if I am considered as a goods goes out from my business, that's why it's a real account. Okay, next, sales return, again same, sales return and sales, purchase and purchase return, 4 accounts are real account as well as nominal account. Next, purchase return, again real and nominal, purchase account real and nominal, and last one is goods destroyed by fire account. See, I told you in my last lecture that any goods goes out other than sales or purchase return, goods destroyed by fire, goods burned by fire, goods given as a free sample, goods taken as a for the personal use, or goods given to the donation, all that time, if we are say that goods goes out from the business other than sales or purchase return, it's a real account. It's a real account whenever goods goes out to the business, right? So the last one is your real, as well as goods destroyed by fire. See, goods destroyed by fire is your, if you are taking consider as a goods destroyed by fire, it's a real account, but it is expenses of the business. See, goods destroyed by fire, that's why here in the business loss is there. So you can say it's also our expenses. So here both types of accounts, real accounts as well as nominal accounts. Okay, I hope you complete these in both the ways, that is here the name of account, types of account and explanation is given, and 50 account is given, and then classification in 3 types of accounts, purchase, real, sorry, personal, real and nominal. And you have to classify them in a natural personal account, legal artificial personal account, goods account, assets account, income account and expense account. Okay, so I hope you all done this. If not, please do in your Facebook. Right, now next point, is illustration number 6. What is that? First of all, I am giving you here 2 minutes to read illustration number 6 and the next rule on the next page, page number 42, all the rules of personal, real and nominal account, and then I explain you. Okay, so first of all, read page number 41 and 42. Okay, see now, here I am reading the illustration number 6, transactions in reference to expenses and types of account. See, here I already told you all these things by this way. Here all the expenses are given and the word outstanding, receivable, payable, accrued are given, then it's a personal account, other than it's a nominal account. Here the same thing is given. Salary, if the first transaction is salary, that is your nominal account, it's business expense. Salary outstanding or salary paid in advance, paid / received in advance, then again it's a personal account. Salary outstanding is a personal, salary paid in advance is also a personal account. Again, rent paid, it's nominal. Only these particular account are there, then it's a nominal account. And if the word outstanding, paid, received in advance, receivable, payable, accrued, all the words are attached with this particular expense or income account, then it will become a personal account. Sir, just see that rent paid, nominal, rent outstanding, rent paid in advance, personal, commission paid, nominal, commission outstanding, commission paid in advance, personal, brokerage paid, nominal, brokerage outstanding, brokerage paid in advance are personal accounts. And under that, see, now this is the expenses account. Now the income account, commission received, received, what is that? That's why commission, interest, salary, all are your expense as well as income. If the word paid is there, then it is your expense. If the word received is there, then it is your income. Commission received is your nominal account, income account. Commission outstanding or commission received in advance, both are, you can say, a personal account. Okay, so here are the examples of all the expenses and income as well as all the personal accounts which is attaching the words outstanding, paid in advance, received in advance, etc., etc. Okay, so we already understood that. You just have to write these two into your fair book. Okay, example book, you have to write illustration 6, first all the expenses, then all the income transactions and their types of accounts. Now the main thing is the rule of this particular account. See here, next topic, see the next topic here is, first of all, we show the business transactions, then classify into the transactions, economic, non-economic, cash, credit, then we show the effect of affected accounts of that particular transaction, that is dual effect of transactions. Now that two accounts, we have to classify them into three types, personal, real and nominal. Now apply the rules of each types of accounts. We have to apply the rules. Now first of all, we have to classify them into three types, personal account, real account and nominal account. If the classification is over, then we have to apply the rule of that particular account. See here, I am writing out the rules, and it is important for compulsory, and it is very 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 important for you. See here, personal account, what is the rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. See, in the personal account, who are the receiver, we have to debit that particular person account into our books of account, right? And who are the giver? We have to credit that particular person account in our books of accounts, right? Okay, this is the rule for personal accounts. See, first of all, I am reading all these things and then write the personal, real and nominal accounts rules. See here on page number 42. In this chapter, we have studied dual effect of transactions in point number 5. Under double entry system, accounting as per the its name, it is a method to give two effects of transactions. We complete up to this dual effect of transaction. While giving two-fold effect, it may affect two or more than two accounts. Here, two or more than two accounts are affected, right? See, transactions of business is also made between two parties compulsory. This is the business transactions classification, right? We have acquired information of dual effect in the form of first effect and second effect. That is, we already show in illustration number 3, in each and every transactions, which first account is affected and which second account is affected. We have to show that particular thing in illustration number 3. First effect means debit effect of transactions. See here, whatever the first effect, that is compulsory debit effect, and whatever the second effect, that is compulsory a credit effect. Okay, from the above presentation, it can be said that the dual effect of transactions means first debit effect and the second credit effect. In brief, every transactions of the business has effect means debit and credit. Each and every transactions has two effects. First effect is debit effect and second one is credit effect. Okay, there are predetermined rules in accounting for debit effect and credit effect. Debit and credit rules are made for the following three accounts. Here I told you that at the time of classification of accounts, there are two types of first of all there are two types of accounts, personal and impersonal. And in impersonal, there are two types of accounts again, real and nominal. So at that time, I am showing you that you have to concentrate only on three. First is personal, second is real, and the third one is nominal. And for that, the rules are there for debit and credit. There are the rules for the personal account, real account, as well as nominal account. Personal account. Any person taking benefit from the business or giving benefit to the business. What is personal account? See, if any person is taking the benefit from me, that is debit the receiver. He are taking the benefit. That's why he is a receiver. That's why their account is debited. And if any person giving me any the benefit, then he is a giver. And giver account is always credited. Okay, so for personal account, any person taking benefit from the business or any person giving benefit to the business. Now for the real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. See here, real account means what? All the assets account, right? So assets comes into the business, then it is debited. If all the assets goes out from the business, then it's a credit. See, in simple, if we are taking purchase account as a real account, we are purchasing the goods. That's why assets comes into the business. That's why personal account, purchase account is always debited. At the time of sales, what is that? Sales at the time, here I am giving a goods. That means goods goes out from the business. That's why here sales account is credited. So for all the purchase and sales, purchase is a debited and sales is credited. Again, if I am purchasing a furniture for my business, right? So if the furniture comes into the business, that's why furniture account is debited. And If I sold old furniture from my business, then furniture goes out from the business. That's why that at that time furniture account is credited. Okay, so for a real account, increase, that is receipt of goods or assets in the business, and decrease, that is a decrease of goods or assets into the business, comes in or goes out. Receipt, that is comes in, given, or you can say decrease, that is goes out from the business. So the rule for real account is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Okay, and the third one, nominal account. What is the nominal account? See, all the expenses is there and all the incomes is there. That's why the rule for nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. If any expenses and loss are there, see, we have to debit it. And if any income or gain is there, then we have to credit it. See, the occurrence of expenses loss of the business, that is debit, first effect. And realization of income and gain to the business, that is credit, second effect. Right? So here in the table, page number 42, the table, in that, into the table, the rule is given, personal account, debit the receiver, and the second effect, credit the giver. First effect of the transactions means debit effect of transactions is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Again, real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Again, for nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Right? So first effect is the debit effect and the second effect is the credit effect of the accounts. Okay, now see, in brief, personal account, real account and nominal account, rule of personal, rule of real and rule of nominal accounts is explained in our next 7, 8 and 9 example. So now you have a homework. See here, what is your homework? Complete your fair book, or you can say example book, up to illustration number 6. That is, you have to complete 1 to 6 illustration all in your example book. Then read page number 42 to 45, or you can say this is the next lecture reading, and also you have to refer or read, you have to also read all page number 24 to 41 to refer this chapter again. Okay, so here you have a homework, that complete your fair book up to illustration number 6. So illustration number 7, 8, 9 and 10, which we'll do in our next lecture, and also refer full chapter. Okay, and anytime you have any doubts, then WhatsApp me, ask me. Okay, I am complete here my lecture. Thank you, class.